All right, I'm Dave Ratt, and today let's take a look at comparing the Behringer X32 to an Allen and Heath QU16. I know there's a lot of fans of both consoles. The actual feature set of these two consoles does not compare. The X32 is much more complex, more inputs, more effects. Everything is significantly more, and it costs more as well. And this Allen and Heath, less expensive console, it rack mounts. What I'm looking at here, though, is not the effects, not the feature set, but the fundamental format and the way these consoles present information to us as engineers, and how that trying to look at or wonder or to ponder about how that affects the way that we mix. A lot of people really swear by Allen and Heath. They say they sound great, they love them, and the feature set is not as important to them. Even on the more expensive boards that have the feature sets, the X32, again, a lot of fans. There's a lot of bias, a lot of opinions. I don't have any of that. Personally, I like the Midas Heritage H3000 and the XL4. I've toured with those around the world. I've been an analog engineer for 4 decades. I stopped mixing when things kind of went to digital. I still carried analog for a long time. I love analog consoles, and I'm familiar with the way the analog presents information, where things distort, and the sound qualities of that. Digital, the shift. There's two real fundamental ways that the information in metering is presented. The X32 and M32, which for the test that I'm going to do today, perform exactly the same for these aspects, presents it in the digital in the digital method, where the metering is minus 60 to 0, and 0 being clip, and the nominal level, like the 0 dB of an analog console, that kind of neutral level is minus 18. On the QU16, it's set up to look and feel like an analog console. It's just three LEDs in the channels with a signal, a zero, and a peak. And then the output meter is minus 40 to plus 12, plus, and then the peak beyond that, which is more how the analog consoles would be presented. Two different formats. Let's see how they respond to signal. Let's hear when they distort. And I don't know, take a look at that. I definitely have some opinions on the way information is presented can have a significant impact on the way sound engineers mix, especially if they're not super familiar with stuff and the ramifications. All right, so we'll start with, I've got a SoundTools mic switcher here with the A position is the QU16, the B position is the X32. I've got a tone generator here set at 200 hertz. I've got a Duros meter here, 1 dB increments. It's set at plus 20. So when we see those three LEDs that are red in the middle one is 0 dB, and it says 0, but we're at plus 20, so it's actually plus 20. And I've got an oscilloscope here. The yellow is the signal of, oops, is the signal of whatever console we're looking at, and the pink or red is the actual split off from the generator. It's the signal being sent. All right, so I'm going to crank this up, and we'll take a look, and we hear that here on the little Bose speaker. Oh, I got a little Bose speaker hooked up to this analog console. This analog console is this little Xenix is set up just to control the Bose speaker because it can't handle the output and just to deal with the signal levels, so we can hear what we're doing. So I'm going to bring this, let's take a look at the X32, and as this comes up, let's look at this input meter, and we see the two green LEDs down here. The gain on the console, on both consoles, is set at plus 20. And we're at 0.3 volts input. We have the two green LEDs lit, which is minus 30. And when we go to plus 0.4, 0.4 volts. We get the minus 18, which is the 0 dB mark on the Allen and Heath. Let's go ahead and crank this up until we see the first red light on the X32. There it is. And let's look at the meter, and we are at plus 1 on the Duro's meter, or plus 21, because 20 dB up. And let's give it a little more juice. And as soon as we go to plus 22, we hear this fuzz. I think you can hear that. I'll make it worse. I'm going to bring this down here so we're not clipping on this board. No, we're not. And we can see that in the yellow waveform. Clean, starting to buzz. There's that distortion. That clipping is not good. That's a bad sound. That's not the warmth of an analog preamp that people talk about getting using analog gear for. That is square waving, and it just creates hash. And it's happening. We see the red LED there. And 1 dB higher, we go into clip. So red LED is lighting up just the slightest audible increment, 1 dB, before square waving and sounding bad. What that tells me is, if you're mixing on an X32 or an M32, which responds exactly the same, if you see red clip lights, you are not rocking like a hurricane, you're rocking like an amateur, and you've got some crap sound coming out of that rig, and you're not doing it right. You do not want to see the red clip light on an X32 or M32 ever. Let's go ahead and take a look at the QU16. So, I'm going to, just for fun, I'll switch over to it while it's live. And now we're on the QU16, and we can see it over here. And let's go ahead and bring that up until we see red. And there we got it, red. So red on this X32 showed up at plus 21. On the QU16, red is showing up at, let me get my glasses here. Red is showing up at the minus 4, we're at plus 20, so it's plus 16. It's showing up 5 dB sooner. Now let's go ahead and give it more juice. Now we're into the red. Now look at these red lights. It's not just a gentle little red light kind of buried and downplayed. This is a bright red LED, as bright, if not the brightest thing on the console, slightly brighter than the greens and yellows. And it's clipping on the channel, and it's showing up on the preamp, and it's showing up in the EQ, and it's showing up in the comp. So I see 4 red lights showing up now, and we've still got a clean signal though. And we're at plus 15, and we're still, now we're at plus 20, plus 21. Oh, I'm starting to hear it. So right at plus 21 going into plus 22, we're starting to see that square wave. So it's putting out the same output as the X32, but it's telling us that we're in that danger zone, and we're getting close to it sounding terrible, 6 dB, 5 or 6 dB before we get there. So you can slightly flash those LEDs before it sounds bad on the QU16. It's a psychological thing, but it's maybe interesting and useful. Let's do this. I'm going to bring down the input to 1.4 dB. Nope, I'm going to go to 1.1 volt. And I'm going to bring up the output until we get to 0. And I see the LED at plus 20. We got the red LED showing up on the console at plus 20. And okay, so on the output of the QU16, the red LED comes up almost the same as it did on the input of the X32. Let's do the input, the output of the X32. X32, bring it right up to the red. And again, we're at plus 21. And it's again. So the output metering of the two consoles is almost the same. When the red light comes on, it is just 1 dB below square waving and getting into that undesirable sound that we do not want to experience as an audience member, and you definitely don't want to present to the audience as a sound engineer. But the input channel has built in 5 or 6 dB of a headroom before the clip light and given us a much brighter indication that we're getting there on the Allen and Heath than it does in the X32. Theoretically, all other things being equal, sound quality and the frequency response and all the other stuff, both consoles should sound very similar when mixed in their respective correct realms. Conversely, if you're an engineer that walks up and kind of looks for a big indicator and you don't stay out of the red and know that you need to stay 6 dB below, you got to be way down in the, you want to, yeah, this minus 6 L below the clip. So you want to be in the minus 18 to minus 12 here will be the same as running 0 to peak here. Or the peak there is like the minus 6 here. All that said, I believe that this is one of the reasons why there's this big gap between the developers of digital consoles and all the testing that is done. I mean, I've tested quite a bit of digital stuff and analog stuff. The digital stuff tests really well. It has great frequency response. It's smooth. It's flat. It doesn't go much above 20K or 24K if at the 48K sample rate. It doesn't go anything above 24K. And at the 96, it can't really get above 48K. The testing of digital, A-B-ing, I mean, you play a CD and tune the rig, the CD's at 44.1. And you tune it on analog rig, you tune it on a digital rig, it sounds great. There's no difference. But I've been to a lot of shows, and it seems like since we've switched to digital and live audio, the quality of many shows is degraded. And I know that digital sound, I know that thinness that I hear it when engineers are mixing on digital. And I'm beginning to believe, and this is confirming it, I didn't expect that coming in, is that this is operator error. People are mixing on digital consoles like they do on an analog console. The Allen and Heath has got us halfway there. It's allowing you to clip the input a bit and not go into overload. But the output is, that red light is over the top. On the X32, red lights are bad all the way around. I'll get into this more. It's still kind of a developing thought. But I find it really interesting. I think that the ergonomics, the indicators, and we also know a lot of that happens with EQ. Analog EQs, you got these third octaves that are 19 inches wide with 30 knobs, and you've got very little up and down for a stereo third octave and three rack spaces, and a lot of horizontal, very little vertical. And so it looks like you're not EQing very much. You convert that over to a digital screen, and you've got that EQ condensed horizontally with a ratio of maybe 2:1 instead of 5:1 or 4:1 of height to width for fader throw. And it looks like you're EQing a lot more on the digital or EQing a lot less in the analog. That perceptive thing where we might not want to EQ too much, so we under EQ in the digital domain. And it seems like we're not doing anything, even though we see a lot going on. Or maybe on a different console, the aspect ratio is different. We feel like we are under EQing and we're actually over EQing. These ergonomic interface aspects are a lot more important than is often taken into account. All right. I will do more with this QU16 as well as bring in the Digico SD11, and maybe I'll go farther down this rabbit hole if I can find some interesting stuff. Cool, cool.